By way of introduction, my name is Andrea Giorgino. I'm an audit partner of Deloitte Cyprus, based in Limassol. I am serving many shipping audit clients, and very regularly I am advising on IFRS technical issues. Today I'm going to speak about the new leasing standard, IFRS 16, that superseded ER 17, the leasing standard that for many years requires a distinction of finance leases and operating leases. I promise today my shipping leader, Kostas Georgakis, to not to talk on technical aspects, so I will provide a very brief and plain presentation on commercial and also accounting implications and what is the impact on shipping as far as the new leasing standard is concerned. I will do so by providing a high-level overview of the concept of IFRS 16, the new leasing standard. Also, look at the impact of the primary financial statements and the key financial metrics by work example information. Very briefly, I will talk about how the rating agencies look on this change in the accounting standard. And finally, I will provide some highlights of some key messages that capture from the global IFRS 16 implementation survey carried out by Deloitte International Office. Thank you very much. Okay, the new leasing standard, IFRS 16, has been issued back in 2016, and the International Accounting Standard Board provided quite a lengthy time for everybody to get prepared and be ready for implementing this 1st January this year, 2019. It is expected that it's really a very lengthy process of capturing all contracts in place that are in the list in to collect all the information, perform the calculations, and come up with the nice figures that your CFOs would like, and also we as auditors put our signature. Okay, the leasing. This new leasing standard is based on controls-based concept. A contract contains or is a lease when conveys the right to control the use of an asset over a period of time in exchange for a consideration. Many retailers rent properties and run their business, make critical decisions what goods to sell, the pricing, and from which suppliers to get the products. The banks do their retail banking by renting property, and in shipping clients and shipping organizations charter in through standard time charters or bareboat arrangements to employ vessels and obtain the right to make critical decisions. How to employ the vessel, where to sail, what cargo, the pricing, which charterers. So these critical decisions generally in shipping has been established that the bareboat agreements and the time charter agreements on a chartering arrangements are within the scope of IFRS 16. So I'm afraid we cannot appeal to IMO, we cannot appeal to Football Association, everywhere. This is our life. We need to live with the new IFRS 16 leasing standard, and there are some nasty consequences. Okay, as lessees, there is no more any off-balance sheet leases. Everything has to be recognized on the balance sheet as lessees. So, in the shipping, time chartering arrangements, bareboat chartering arrangements need to recognize on the date of acquisition, date one, as a present value of the future lease commitments, a lease liability, and on the other side, a right of use on asset as a lease asset. This is a significant change in accounting for leases and will result in boosting the balance sheet, increasing assets and increasing liabilities, unfortunately increasing gearing ratios. Of course, the good news is that boosting the EBITDA, because anymore rental expenses in leases will not be recognized in the income statement and will be substituted with the recognition of amortization of the right of use of assets, a yearly amortization, as well as an imputed interest on the lease liability. Is it clear? Are you following me? This is the most important slide that I want to show to you. Our balance sheet is boosted. Liabilities and assets. Okay. Move more quickly. Let's look. Yes. Yes. As accountants, at initial recognition, the debt is equal to credits. Okay. Okay. Nicolas has a nice question. At initial recognition, assets equals liabilities. Okay. Thereafter, at year end, the interest recognition on the liability is higher compared to the amortization of an amount. So this has increased on the liabilities, and this has a result that more losses are recognized in the income statement at the earlier stages of the lease as compared to the. Thank you, Nicolas, for the note. Okay. Through a work example, I'm going to present how the balance sheet would look like under the new standard, IFRS 16, and compare with the old one. Assuming a ship-owning entity having a fleet of vessels by using an existing bank loan with 78 million outstanding at year end, and due to increased demand, shipping is going better, as I am here from my previous panelists and speakers. So they decide to employ a vessel by entering into chartering, time charter arrangement for $6,000 per day for a period of 10 years plus 2 years optional extra period. It's reasonably certain to extend the option, so the total lease period is 12 years. The incremental borrowing rate decided by the finance team of the company is 6.5% per year. Now, this gives us an initial lease recognition, which is the minimum lease payments discounted at the 6.5% interest of 18,063,000 US dollars. Looking at the balance sheet at the next slide and comparing IAS 17 and IFRS 16 constructed balance sheet, it is striking that the assets under IFRS 16 significantly increased by the recognition of a new asset, leased asset. At the initial recognition, this equals to the present value of the lease commitments over the life of the lease. At the same time, the liabilities also substantially increased by the recognition of the lease liabilities, 16.66% as non-current, and also the current assets, the current liabilities slightly increased as well. This represents the 1.03 million, represents the next year repayment of rental lease less the interest. The equity has been reduced slightly because, as mentioned by Nicolas, there has been a front-loaded recognition of interest which impacted the increasing recognition of interest and a reduction slightly of the equity of the company. What is the impact of the key ratios? Unfortunately, the quick ratio now from positive under IAS 17 now is negative. Our net debt to EBITDA So the servicing ratio, as we know, from 3.9 goes to 4.3. And the equity to debt ratio also has been deteriorating from 28.2 to 22.35%. Looking now at the performance of the entity using the profit and loss income statement, interesting that the operating profit for the year has been increased by 2.16 from 26 to 28.16 due to the fact that there is no new rental expense recognized anymore in the financial statements. At the same time, also the EBITDA has increased, so good news. Okay, EBITDA increased by the same amount, so the OPEX is down. However, depreciation and amortization line increases by the yearly amortization of the lease asset, and the finance cost as well increases by a small amount. All right, summarizing all of this, I try to present a comparison of the key ratios under IAS 17, under IFRS 16 figures, and also adding in the picture some generally used bank covenants in shipping bank loans. So a quick ratio, a positive, the threshold, equity debt ratio 25%, the service ratio EBITDA over service debt 1.3, and net debt over EBITDA, the leverage ratio, as we everybody know, 4. Under IAS 17, a rosy picture. Everything is there, there is no any bank covenant, that is not met. Using IFRS 16 figures, however, it seems that the quick ratio is not met, it's negative. The equity to debt ratio goes down to 22.35%. Is there any covenants that are not met? Question mark. I don't know. I advise you, go and talk to your banker. There is a change on the balance sheet. There is a change of the profile of the profit and loss. There is no more any rental expense recognized on the P&L. There is extra finance charges. There is more depreciation. Maybe your business line bankers wouldn't say that there is any change because nothing changed from the fundamental business point of view. The cash flows are there, the seniority of the debt is the same, the business care is strong. However, the risk department and the IFRS 9, a very nasty, I have to say, nastier than IFRS 16 standard for banking especially, maybe they have a different point of view. So go and talk to your bankers, redefine, discuss, clarify whether there is any, let's say, redefinition and clarifications as far as the definitions of bank covenants. Time is running. I have extra 5 minutes, so no, okay. So I'm sorry about that. So very quickly, I will try to capture some messages of the survey that was globally carried out by Deloitte International regarding implementation issues. The survey was carried out in 21 countries, Cyprus, Germany, UK, Canada, is everywhere, even in Brazil, maybe leasing some football players for Cyprus. Companies. There were 207 participants across varieties of organizations in operating in 10 plus industries, including shipping and transportation, red highlighted, 57% as lessees and 53% as lessors and lessees, mostly issuing financial statements under IFRS, 72%, large capitalized companies, private, and also mid-tier. And closing with the highlights. As expected, 52% of the organizations anticipate that there will be material change. We look at this, our assets increased, the provenance moved plus or minus. Now, very importantly, having performed the gap analysis, these organizations, the respondents, anticipated that the IT systems cannot cope with the changes, with the calculations that we as accountants have to do to come up with a nice balance sheet and asset and liability. So 61% of respondents are considering to use externally developed leasing systems. Talk to your CFOs, go to the market, look for consultancy. 86% of the organizations, time is running, so they are not considering for early adoption. It seems that the lease terms is quite complex in the definition of, in the implementation. And lastly, collection of data and abstracting the data and gathering all the information and all the shippings seems that it's a very time-consuming exercise. So these organizations use external consultants for doing the job.
Thank you very much for your time.